guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Lisa, also known as ladolcelisa, and today's video is a good one. I've actually been waiting quite a while to make this video. I just could not find key lime, but I finally found them so I can show you guys how I make my delicious key lime pie. It is so good. Every time I make it and bring it to like an event, because it is like the perfect thing to bring to a summertime event, so it's great for this time of year. But every time I make it, people always ask me for the recipe, so I figured I might as well film it. I've actually been craving it right now, so I'm excited to eat it as well. So without further ado, let's get started and let's make this delicious homemade key lime pie that is as easy as it is tasty. Okay, so this is actually quite an easy recipe, even though we are going to be making three separate things and then putting them together. So we're going to be making the filling, the crust, and then the whipped cream on top. Now, first things first is actually the filling, because I like to make that and then let that sit for the few minutes that it does take to make and prepare the graham cracker crust. So let's start making the filling. So of course, the most important part of a key lime pie are the key limes. These babies were hard to find, but I finally found them. They are much smaller than just a regular lime, as you can see. You can of course use regular Persian limes for this recipe, but of course this is a key lime pie, so I like to use key limes. The main difference between the two is that these are of course smaller. They have a little bit of a stronger aroma. They're a little bit more acidic and they have more seeds. They also have a thinner rind. They're really good in this pie, but of course if you guys cannot find the key limes, they're a little bit difficult to find, by all means you can use regular limes and it will still be such a delicious pie. So now that these are all washed and dried, I'm going to zest a bit of the key limes first before I actually juice them, just to make my life easier. I have about 1 to 2 teaspoons, I would say more like 2 teaspoons of lime zest here from these lovely key limes. I use exactly about 5 key limes and they're usually around the same size, they're always very little, so just keep that in mind when you're zesting. If you use a regular lime, it may be just the zest of like 1 or 2 limes would be good enough. Now that I've zested these, I'm going to juice them. Your life will be a little bit easier if you can squeeze them in here. They're so tiny, so in order to get 1/3 of a cup of the key lime juice, we're going to probably have to go through, I would say, roughly 10 or so key limes, but we'll see when we get there. So let's start juicing these key limes. So I'm just going to slice it in half and then just squeeze the juice into my cup just to measure it out. If you don't have something so handy as this, a good tip is to roll your limes on a flat surface. That way you release all of the juices inside, and then squeezing them by hand is just easier. I have a feeling if you don't have this juicer, you might go through 1 or 2 more limes than me, because it's a little bit harder to squeeze by hand. This is so handy. So just keep that tip in mind. That way you can release all of the juices from the key lime. So I have my 1/3 of a cup of this key lime juice. I'm literally just going to put it through this little strainer. This is not a necessary step, but it actually does help to remove all of those seeds that might have ended up in here. You don't really want those in your pie. So we're just gonna put them through the strainer. So now that we have the juice and the zest in here, I would say I went through about 12 little baby key limes. Now we are going to add our egg yolks. I have 4 large egg yolks that I already separated. So we're just going to add them right into this mixture. And we're just going to give this a quick whisk. And now to the egg yolks and the limes, we have this delicious sweetened condensed milk. It is honestly so good. If you guys have never used this stuff before, it's essentially what they use to make dulce de leche. So good. So scraping this out might be a little bit of a struggle. Just make sure you get every last drop. This is 300 milliliters. They usually come in these standard size cans. So we're gonna pour that all in. And now we are just going to whisk everything to incorporate all of the ingredients. Okay, so after about a minute or so of whisking, everything seems to have come together quite nicely. I like to make the filling before I even make the pie crust, because I like to let this sit for about 20 minutes or 30 minutes, depending on how long it takes us, just to let all the flavors come together. And now all of those elements, like the citrus mixed with the condensed milk and the yolks, they're going to thicken and it's going to be such a delicious filling, guys. So now that we are done with that, let's set that aside. I'm going to clean up and we are going to get started in making the graham cracker crust for this delicious key lime pie. So now we are ready to make the delicious graham cracker crust. I do mine with a little bit of a twist, which you will see in a second. Now, the first things first is that you probably are going to want to preheat your oven at this stage, so don't mind that background noise if you guys hear it. You'll have to preheat your oven to 325 degrees Fahrenheit. So now in a large bowl, we are going to start making the crust. I will need 2 cups of the graham cracker crumbs. And then to that, my little twist on things is that I like to add slivered almonds. It just makes the crust so delicious. So I have only 1/2 cup of slivered almonds, and I'm going to add this right into these honey graham cracker crumbs. And now this is optional, but I love the warmth of these spices. So I'm just going to be adding 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon right into this mixture. And then to that, I'm just going to be adding 1/4 cup, so 1/4 cup of just plain white sugar right into the mixture. And to that, I'm going to be adding 1/2 cup of unsalted butter. This has been melted in the microwave. It takes about 30 to 40 seconds. So just right into the mixture. And now with a spatula, we're just going to give this a mix to incorporate all of our ingredients. So when this comes together, it should sort of look like wet sand. So if you pack it with your hands, it will stay together. Now what I have here is my pie crust tin. This is sort of like a tart crust tin where the bottom pops off. But I love that when I'm making key lime pies because it is so much easier to slice it after. So to this tin, I'm just going to be adding this graham cracker crust mixture right over here. And I also like to use the back of these measuring tools just to really press in the crust. We can even just use our hands. Sometimes they're the best tools. So we're just going to pack it in. I actually like a nice thick graham cracker crust. It's honestly one of my favorite parts of the whole pie. It is so delicious, especially with these slivered almonds and that warmth of the cinnamon. Those are of course optional. If you choose to omit those, you can just go ahead and use the recipe as is. But I just find that it adds that little extra something, and the almonds just complement these nice key limes so well. So we're just packing in the side of the crust so that we create a wall, and then we want the bottom to be flat, obviously. Oh, perfect timing! So the oven is ready. It has just hit 325, and I have this beautiful crust ready to go in. I'm just putting this down on this baking tray because sometimes when the bottom is open, things can leak out. So a little bit of that like butter can leak out into your oven, and you don't want that. So always bake your pies on a nice tray like this. So I just put the crust into the oven right now, and we are just going to blind bake that basically without the filling inside for just 10 minutes. And then we are going to add the filling, and then we are going to bake it again. Now that it has come out of the oven, it is still obviously warm. We are ready to add the filling. The filling has been chilling out there for, I would say, a good 20 minutes, so it's good to go. Now we're just going to add this to the pie crust, and then we are going to bake this for an additional 15 minutes. So the total baking time for this is about 25 minutes, but this stage is just 15 minutes because we just want it to set nicely and obviously to cook those egg yolks a little bit. So you can see that the mixture is thick. We are now going to get a spatula and add this to this delicious crust. So now we are going to be returning this pie to the oven, this time with the delicious filling, for 15 minutes at the same temperature, 325. This delicious key lime pie has just finished baking, so now all of the hard work is pretty much over. We just have to wait and then eventually make our whipped cream. So this just came out of the oven after 15 minutes and it is absolutely perfect. We are going to let this cool down to room temperature before we put it in the fridge. So let this cool down for about 45 minutes at room temperature and then pop it into the fridge for about 3 hours to really set and chill, or even overnight, and you can eat it the next day, of course, but I will see you guys in 3 hours because I really want to eat this key lime pie. It has been exactly 3 hours and I am now ready to make the whipped cream for the delicious key lime pie. So first things first, we need heavy whipping cream. This is 35% and I need 2 cups. I'm pretty sure this whole thing is exactly 2 cups, but just to be safe, let's measure. And I'm adding this to my KitchenAid stand mixer. You can of course use a hand electric mixer, or you can even just whip it by hand, but just for the convenience of things, I'm just gonna use this. So to the 2 cups of the heavy whipping cream, I'm now going to add just 1/4 cup of white sugar. And now we are going to give this a whip to incorporate before we add our coconut element. And now to that very lightly sweetened whipped cream, I'm going to be adding 1/2 cup of coconut. I have actually toasted this coconut. It is a medium dissection of coconut and it's going to be so delicious in this. This coconut is unsweetened, like I said, but if you prefer a sweeter whipped topping, you can get the sweetened coconut. So by all means, it's sort of up to your taste buds. I just wanted this to be not so sweet because we're putting this on this already sweet pie. So I'm adding this to the whipped cream, giving it just a quick whip to incorporate, and then it should be done and ready to pipe. I like to really make sure that this whipped cream is nice and whipped because we're going to be piping it on. So we don't want a loose whipped cream. We want it to be very, very thick and delicious. Now, just in case I haven't already mentioned before, I toasted the coconut just quickly on a pan. So I just got a pan, I added the coconut, and I lightly toasted it on a medium heat until it started to turn that beautiful golden color. Then I took it off the heat and let it cool fully to room temperature before I added it to my whipped cream. That is very important. You don't want to add anything warm to the cream. Okay, so I have my gorgeous key lime pie, but what is key lime pie without whipped cream? And this is toasted coconut whipped cream. So it's gonna be so good. So I have it fitted in this piping bag, and now we are just going to pipe, I think, little dollops around the edge of this pie. It looks really cute that way, so let's decorate and then we can eat. Decorating is just basically how you wish. You could just really do whatever. Just gonna move this little lime to the side, and now I'm going to cut myself a delicious slice of this pie. And now all that's left is to eat. Bon appetit. Let's get myself a nice little bite with also some of this coconut whipped cream. Wow. This is seriously the best key lime pie you'll ever have. That crust is like so good. It is so stable. It cut really nicely. It's absolutely perfect. With the addition of the almonds, those slivered almonds in it, oh my gosh, and that creamy filling from the key limes and that delicious coconut whipped cream, which is not too sweet. It is like the perfect dessert. Guys, my mouth is watering. I have to have another bite. I'm literally going to take this pie and finish it off camera, but I just wanted to say, if you need this recipe, go to my website, ladolcelisa.com. I'll have the exact measurements and instructions written on ladolcelisa.com, so please check that out for further information. And as well, guys, this is a dessert that has limes in it, and I did make that warning not to use limes and go in the sun, so I'm also going to link that video down below as well. But with that aside, guys, this is so delicious. It is perfect. It has like every single note that you want. A little bit sweet, a little bit tart, creamy. There's a crispiness to it. It is such a delicious pie. And it's so easy to make. If you can't find key limes, like I said, just use regular limes and you will be on your way to a delicious key lime pie. But thank you again so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bon appetit! Sir, but you can of course use a whip, or you can a whip. Element. Oh my god. I don't know if it's recording. Mm-hmm.